Don't quit, because you know what? You are going to win.
A strong leader in a proud Latina, known as a strong activist in the Latino community. But she's not stopping anytime soon.
It's a puente in the snow. Entonces, hey. I'm Dolores Huerta, a president and founder of the Dolores Huerta Foundation for Grassroots Community Organizing and co-founder of the United Farm Workers of America.
Huerta is an iconic figure in the Latin community with an impressively long list of accomplishments. Over her lifetime, she has lobbied for justice, changing dozens of laws. She has songs written about her, her face plastered on murals across the country, and films inspired by her. She was even granted the Presidential Medal of Freedom from President Obama for her achievements. Her story starts in 1930 in Dawson, New Mexico, where she was born to a coal mining unionist father and entrepreneur mother.
I was kind of an activist as a teenager and as a young kid.
Her family moved from New Mexico to Stockton, California, where she spent most of her childhood and got her first taste for organizing.
With one of the social clubs I belonged to, we would have dances, and then all of the money that we made, it would go into making charity baskets that we would pass out to poor people at Thanksgiving and Christmas, you know. But I never felt that that was quite doing the job.
Huerta set out to change things.
And I learned that you could really make changes, political changes and policy changes, by organizing people.
In 1955, at age 25, she founded the Stockton Community Service Organization, which succeeded in passing a range of vital laws.
And we passed a lot of really important laws, like getting driver's license and in Spanish, getting the ballots to vote in Spanish.
But she was just getting started with some of her biggest achievements yet to come. In the 1960s, the Californian agricultural industry was taking off, aided by immigrants from Latin America and Asia flocking to the fertile land to work the crops. However, many crop growers took advantage of the workers.
They worked long hours for low pay, had no medical care, no accident or unemployment insurance, no sanitary facilities in the fields, and worst of all, no mechanism for expressing their grievances or improving their lot.
In 1962, Huerta and her associate, Cesar Chavez, deeply affected by the plight of farm workers, co-founded the National Farm Workers Association, now known as the United Farm Workers. Huerta and the UFW began organizing the Delano grape strike.
A lot of people think that the strike was very spontaneous. It wasn't. We had not planned to go on strike till 1968. And then 1965, the Filipino workers went out on strike. And so, you know, we had to support them because they were the minority of the farm workers. And it lasted for 5 years, from 1965 to 1970.
Hundreds of farm laborers walked off the job and picketed outside the headquarters of the largest grape growers. Cesar Chavez began a 25-day hunger strike. Some even started a 300-mile pilgrimage from Delano to Sacramento.
10,000 strong came swinging up the Capitol Mall to the steps of the state Capitol building. It was beyond question the largest, the broadest, and the most significant public gathering on behalf of farm workers in California history.
It was Huerta's boycott that helped tip the balance.
And the only way that we were able to win is that we started a boycott of California table grapes in 1968. A whole group of farm workers they traveled in a school bus all the way to New York City. So they went all over the country there telling the story. And so at the end of the day, we were able to get 17 million Americans to stop eating grapes. It within a year and a half that we were able to get the growers to come to the table and sign contracts.
Huerta led the negotiations, managing to get the growers to agree to a raise in wages, bumping the farmers up from $8.40 an hour to $13.72 an hour, a more than 60% increase in pay. The growers also agreed to set aside money for health care and benefits, establish a formal grievances process, and regulate the use of pesticides. The strike had ripple effects, setting off a chain of boycotts and collective action, which resulted in 30,000 new contracts being signed, providing higher wages and benefits.
knowing that farm workers who worked under union contracts are getting a pension check every month after they've retired. You know, that to me is a good feeling, knowing that so many people that went to jail, people that got beaten up, you know. So when you think of all of these people, and I get the recognition, but it's on the backs of all of the hundreds of farm workers who went on strike and our martyrs, people who were killed.
Today, farm workers have far more rights than they did in the 60s and 70s, thanks to Huerta and her colleagues, but remain a disenfranchised group. They are predominantly Hispanic, have lower educational attainment than average, and are more likely to be non-citizens than in other industries. But where there's a change to be made, Huerta will be there. She recently joined farm workers in Sacramento after they walked 335 miles from Delano in protest, a nod to her legacy.
I want to ask the governor not only to sign the bill, but to get the growers together and tell them they don't get any more legislation unless they recognize the farm workers union, okay?
And the slogan she coined for the United Farm Workers can still be heard chanted today, an anthem for other activist groups as well. In English, yes, we can. At 92 years old, more than 50 years since the Delano grape strike, Huerta looks to the future of activism.
Women's marches, you know, the Me Too marches, the marches after George Floyd was killed, you have the same kind of fervor that was happening then. And it's like the 60s with steroids. Once people realize that they can make a difference, I mean, it is so exhilarating. I mean, they feel their power and they know that they can do something about the issues that are confronting them.
La victoria va a cumplir.